This edition of the Riddler Report is brought to you by
Next 1000.
All right, so I'll start. I am thankful to have you guys here tonight to do the live show here, and I'm thankful for all of my wonderful people that that help out with this show in the co-host chairs and everybody that comes in to do the Sunday shows, which I think have been a tremendous success so far this year. People have had a lot of positive things to say about the folks that the guys that are normally in the third chair during the week coming in on Sundays. If you haven't heard that yet, you can do that Sunday nights, including this weekend, from 7 to 10 o'clock at freetalklive.com. Also appearing on LRN.FM. And of course, I appreciate all the shows that we picked up over at LRN.FM and Ernie Hancock and Anti-War Radio with Scott Horton coming on board. And even though they took the day off today, I appreciate them being here and being on the air every single day. What is it like, Scott? I mean, Scott Horton's got a girlfriend and he wants to spend time with her. I understand. Ernie's got, you know, family and he wants to spend time with them.
Poor lonely old Ian all by himself in his house. Doesn't have anybody to spend his time with.
That's not
true. You do it anyway.
That's not true.
You do the show anyway.
Oh, of course I would. Yeah. Absolutely. So, yeah. And I appreciate, you know, being here now, as I was mentioning before. It's great to be alive at this time. It's an exciting time when, you know, technology is increasing at such an amazing clip.
Indeed.
And we have the ability to spread these ideas, the ideas of freedom and consensual interaction between human beings, to get these powerful ideas out into people's minds in ways that have heretofore been impossible to achieve. And so that's pretty exciting. The prospects for freedom, I say, are very bright.
I love you, cutie.
It's easy to be, you know, it's easy to disdain. It's easy to be depressed about all of the negativity in the world, about the war and the killing and the governments and the people they hurt and the people they threaten. It's easy to fall into that trap. But I can tell you it's a lot easier to be positive when you're around other people that are of like mind. So I really appreciate everybody that's moved to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project and everybody that's going to move to New Hampshire and everybody that's considering moving to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. Or maybe if you can't, anybody that just supports the Free State Project and the different activism that's going on here, whether it's Free Keene or Free Grafton or the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance, because you can still support Civilist Obedience Evolution Fund. You can still support financially what's happening, the exciting activism that's happening here, even if you feel like you're tied down and you have to stay where you are. And I still appreciate everybody that's working for liberty around the world, not just the folks here in New Hampshire. I'm most excited about the stuff that's happening here.
Seems more effective, but without, you know, people, anybody will stand up.
Right. Well, without people talking about liberty around the world, then things would be worse off, I think. So I'm glad for everybody, and I appreciate everybody that listens to this show and all of our wonderful advertisers and sponsors, whether they're still on with us or they've been on in the past or you're going to come on in the future, and especially all of our radio stations, everybody that you know, helps behind the scenes at those stations to help get us on, all the board operators, engineers, program directors. Thank you so much for helping make this show possible. Without all of you guys and the Free Talk Live amplifiers, of course, the people that are actually financially directly behind the show, and without all of you, this would not be possible. And we're certainly without the internet, we wouldn't be here. None of this would have been possible in the first place. You wouldn't have been able to, you know, help us one iota, because you never would have heard the show at all if it weren't for the technological age we are in. We would not have existed 20 years ago.
Thank you, Al Gore, for creating the internet. It's so awesome that he did that for us.
So yeah, that's a lot of what I'm thankful for. It's nice to be healthy and alive at this time. And so there you go. That's what I'm thankful for. That's, this year.
Well, very articulate.
I do this stuff every day to some extent, and I usually do what they call affirmations. You know, you're speaking about what you appreciate, whether out loud or to yourself quietly on a daily basis. I think it's a very important thing to do, and I felt really cheesy doing it the first times when I had heard the suggestion about how helpful they can be. I thought, oh my god, this is so lame. But now I do it every single day, and I think it's great.
Well, you know, when you were talking about the Free State Project, I don't know that I'm I guess thankful. I feel kind of lucky that that the Free State Project to me has achieved what I imagined it was going to set out to do. When I signed up for the Free State Project, my expectation was that a bunch of liberty lovers would get together and then we would have an effect on the government of the state of New Hampshire and be able to I didn't really articulate this in my mind, but essentially create a libertarian veto that would stave off the growth of the state. Much easier to do that than to actually shrink the size of the state. And, that happened here in New Hampshire in 2010, this year. I'd love to see how it's going to pan out and everything. But right now, before they actually take office and perhaps turn into something that aren't, so liberty lover, such indicative of liberty lovers. Today, I have the expectation that they will do the right thing. So I feel really lucky to be here in New Hampshire at this time when things are happening at the way I had envisioned them for the Free State Project.
They're going to keep happening in more and better ways as more people come here.
Yeah, I mean, obviously the finish line hasn't been reached, but we reached the goal that I imagined in 2004, 2005.
Already.
When I signed up for the Free State Project. Here we are. Yay, we win.
And we've barely even got the training wheels off yet. I mean, it officially hasn't even, the ball hasn't gotten rolling, really.
There's not 1,000 people that have claimed to move to the state on the website. With 850 people, this is what has happened. To me, it's a huge victory. Obviously, there's a long way to go and all those things, but I think that's great. Everybody says they're thankful for the family, but I got to tell you, I'm the happiest I've ever been in my entire life. This
That's
was
great.
The happiest year of my life. I've got a little boy who is just a joy to watch. He's the only child of two doting older parents, and he is spoiled as he could possibly be. But, I really enjoy, Jack and my life. I, thanks to the listeners and the advertisers of Free Talk Live, I'm able to spend my time at home.
Why is it that hundreds of liberty lovers have moved and continue to move to New Hampshire? In part, it's because of the Free State Project's first 1,000 pledge. The success of that pledge gave this man an idea. Max Abramson of New Hampshire is starting what he calls
the Next 1,000 Pledge,
designed to get another 1,000 Free Staters into New Hampshire by 2011. To find out more, visit pledgebank.com/next1000.